who, what?
Well, the what is geography is destiny. And the who is Ian Morris. Britain and the World, a 10,000 year history. Actually, this book carries on from starts out from a million BC, but it covers a lot of history in the 10,000 years. It is from Farrar, Straus, and Giroux Press, New York. Oh. When Britain voted to leave the European Union in 2016, the 48% who wanted to stay and the 52% who wanted to go accused each other of stupidity, fraud, and treason. In reality, the Brexit debate merely reran a script written 10,000 years earlier, when the rising seas physically separated the British Isles from the European continent. Ever since, geography has been destiny, yet it is humans who decide what the destiny means. Ian Morris, the critically acclaimed author of Why the West Rules for Now, describes how technology and organizations have steadily enlarged Britain's arena and how its people have tried to turn this to their advantage. For the first 7,500 years, the British were never more than bit players at the western edge of a European stage, struggling to find a role among bigger, richer, and more sophisticated continental rivals. In 1500 CE, however, new kinds of ships and governments had turned the European stage into an Atlantic one, with the English Channel now functioning as a barrier. England transferred the British Isles into a united kingdom that created a worldwide empire. Since 1900, thanks to rapid globalization, Britain has been overshadowed by American, European, and increasingly Chinese actors. In trying to find its place in a global economy, Britain has been looking in all the wrong places. The 10,000-year story brazenly chronicled by Geography is Destiny shows the great question for the current century is not what to do about Brussels, it's what to do about Beijing. Well, there's Ian. Is the Jane and Rebecca Wilford Professor of Classics and a Professor of History at Stanford. He is the author of the critically acclaimed Why the West Rules for Now, has published many scholarly books, has directed excavations in Greece and Italy. He lives in the Santa Cruz Mountains in California. Now, this is another book. Now, it has a lot of maps in here. And, well, because geography has a lot of maps. But there are some a lot of little graphs and stuff. Here's the thing with, start out with a million years, or 6,000 to 400 BC, and the first thing they come out with is Margaret Thatcher. We're inextricably part of Europe, Margaret Thatcher told Britain in 1975. Neither Mr. Foote nor Mr. Benn, the chief Brexiters of the day, nor anyone else will ever be able to take us out of Europe, for Europe is where we are and where we have always been. It's called Thatcher's Law. What's an amazing part here is that a long time ago, Britain, on this little map, it shows that Britain was never part of by itself. And of course, the movement of the continents and the continental shift moved somewhat, but it's really the inundation of the inundation of water after the ice sheets melted. And then he talks a lot about after humans were here for several thousand years, then they started getting agriculture. So I went from hunter-gatherers, which is the normal, to sedentary and agricultural endeavors. A lot of it started with trade. building boats. That was the big thing. Boats got us around. Well, here's the British stage, 1 million BCE to 4,000. So, I don't know why it shows the English Channel at 1 billion years, because it was not there. It came in about 13,000. It only took a few thousand years to really make that gulf between Western Europe and British Isles. So it's a fascinating book. Now that I'm looking at it, there's very few graphs at all in here. But there's maps galore, every page or every other page. And it has different ones. It shows the United Kingdom along the Atlantic coast in 1162. So a lot of people, a lot of people came from France. And they tried to keep a lot of conquest and trade and everything in France, because I guess it was the closest. But then, of course, we had those darn Danes and Anglo-Saxons, and they came in and changed. Now, King Arthur was in the 400s, supposedly, and then down by Cornwall. And he tried to unite and bring everything under a domination, but actually it was the later kings. And then Normans came across in 1066, and things have just never been a static system. It's always been dynamics. And then Scotland, and then there was a unification by force, of course, I guess, you know, Braveheart and William Wallace and all of that. And then the Romans earlier, they came in and did their little thing. They never got to Ireland, though. They were threatening, though, but Ireland was left alone for a long time. And so they developed their own cultures and Celts. The Picts were in Scotland. And then after England became its forces in, they left Wales alone. So Wales was kind of like a different nation for a while. And then coal changed everything. But then, of course, in the domination of the seas and discovery in America, colonization. Now, these are all these things that happened came from the people that stayed in the British Isles. But they had appetites and big eyes for other things. And that's how their influence came around. A lot of science came from these people. It's where Isaac Newton in the Royal Academy of Sciences, and Faraday and Maxwell and all of these people really made great discoveries and changes. The rail system in the world got started in England, basically, 1825 approximately. And boy, once that Industrial Revolution took off, that really pumped up. Then you got the colonialism. Of course, they started out, America was its big colonial, but they got India, and then they took part of India away from the French, and India never got its independence till 1947, after World War II. So England got whittled down in its holdings throughout the world. But it became a financial center and Bank of England and all of that. It's just a wonderful country. I've been to England and, they're jolly good people. Well, anyway, we got this book at the Tucson Public Library here in Tucson. You can probably get it at your book. It's a little bit of a read. He doesn't keep a lot of, there's illustration and notes and stuff, but they're not a real thick amount. Some books are about a third of bibliography and all. But this one's a pretty concise read, and if you want, It talks about many, many things. It talks about people, history. Once it gets over the early stuff of the land masses and the movement of the land and all that, and then it gets into mostly what happened with people and events. And so that's mostly what the book is about. But the geography is the place and how it came to be. But it's the tenaciousness of, well, the people that made this book. Well, that made this story for this book. Thanks for watching my reading What Who. Well, what is destiny? Geography is destiny. Written in the world like 10,000 year history. And the who is Ian Morris. Thanks for watching KRAZTV. Watch all of our book reviews. And